In this video, I'll give you an overview of all the new features on Copilot Studio announced during the just-ended Microsoft Build conference, broken down by micro-categories, multi-agent support, models, knowledge, tools, analytics, publishing, application lifecycle management. So follow me to stay ahead of the curve and know everything you need to build powerful solutions with Copilot Studio. Rather than relying on a single agent to do everything or managing disconnected agents in silos, organizations can now build multi-agent systems in Copilot Studio where the agents delegate tasks to each other. In this demo, we have a banking agent that helps customers with their banking needs, for example, checking account balances, transferring funds, report a stolen card, and so on. Previously, you would have to build a single agent with all of these capabilities. Now, instead, you can break a complex agent down into many connected agents, each one specialized in a single functionality. Okay? As we can see here, we have the balance agent, the branch information agent, and so on. If we go into one of these agents, we can still control its details, instructions, knowledge, and tools. If we test it, we can see how the main agent is capable of orchestrating the other agents, knowing when to call each. In this case, I want to transfer money, therefore the transfer funds agent is being invoked. And of course, we get into the flow of this agent. Adding a new agent is very easy. You can see here, I can add an agent from Copilot Studio or the Microsoft 365 SDK, Microsoft Fabric, Azure AI Foundry. And in future, you will even be able to connect to third-party agents via the agent-to-agent protocol. For example, we have here a data agent made with Fabric, so we can publish it in Fabric, and then we can go into Copilot Studio. From here, we can navigate to the section Agents and add the data agent that we just published. And the data agent is now one of the tools that the master agent can invoke. We have also a new multi-language capability for testing the generative orchestrator. I can now write, the same question in any language that Copilot supports. For example, we can see here from the settings, we can see that we have configured this agent in Spanish. And coming back to the testing panel, I'm able to switch from English to Spanish and test it in Spanish. Microsoft now provides a catalog of managed agents, so you can browse them and install from inside Copilot Studio. These agents are complete solutions that you can use as a template and customize for your needs. I'll briefly show you here a demo of one of these agents, the Document Processor Agent. Basically, once selected, you'll go through a configuration wizard so that you have all the steps that you need to tailor that particular agent for your specific scenario. A feature that was long awaited is Copilot Tuning. Copilot Tuning allows you to fine-tune large language models by using your own data. That's implemented in a task-specific fashion, let's say a controlled way. Let's see an example. The first step is configuring your model. Click Create New, next you will provide the model name, description, the description of the task that you would like to accomplish, and then select a customization recipe tailored to the specific task type. Next, you'll give the model instructions to help it identify and prepare the most relevant data from your SharePoint sites. Next, we need to provide the training data or the knowledge, which forms the foundation of your fine-tuned model. Currently, only SharePoint sources are supported. Final step is configuring who can use the fine-tuned model to build agents in Microsoft 365 Copilot by using security groups. Now that the model is configured, you are ready to prepare your training data with data labeling. Data labeling is the process of identifying the best example that you want on a model to learn from. Once your data are processed, you will receive an email notification indicating that your data is ready for labeling. Now, the model you have fine-tuned can be used in Microsoft 365 Copilot Agent Builder. So from there, from the new Copilot interface, you select Create Agent and you will be prompted to select the purpose of your agent, general purpose or task specific. You select task specific to see the list of fine-tuned models that are available to you. You select a model, then from now on, you proceed to building and customize your agent as usual. Let's continue to explore what other new capabilities we have in terms of fine-tuning LLM models in Copilot Studio. We are now offered the possibility to fine-tune the model used by Copilot Studio while building our agents in two different ways, at agent level and at tool level. Let's start with a demo of the customization at agent level. We have our agent here. You notice in the details the response model setting. It's set to the default GPT-4o. Let's go now to the settings. In the Generative AI tab, we have now a drop-down to change the primary response model. We have some preset options, plus the possibility to connect to AI Foundry and select our own published models from AI Foundry. The second way how we can introduce a fine-tuned model in our Copilot Studio agents is via the prompt tool. The prompt tool allows you to specify a task to be completed by Copilot Studio, describing it in natural language, and Copilot Studio will call it when it reckons necessary. As you can see, now you have the possibility to specify a model for your prompt. You have some of the manager models already available for you, those curated by Microsoft, and in addition, it's also possible to access to the 1900 plus Azure AI Foundry models based on your specific use case. Copilot Studio is making progress on the knowledge management section as well. For example, now it supports SharePoint lists. Also, it supports individual instructions at knowledge level, as well as grouping files together while uploading them so that they are treated like one knowledge only, where you can also put instructions on them. We can see actually a demo of this, so you can see we are uploading a group of files together and we are writing instructions at the knowledge level. I think computer use is probably by far the most impressive tool added to Copilot Studio. Unfortunately, it's going to be available only for big customers in USA, at least for now. Computer use allows Copilot Studio agents to interact with desktop applications and websites like a person would, clicking buttons, navigating menus, typing in fields, and adapting automatically as the interface changes. This opens the door to automating complex UI-based tasks like data entry, invoice processing, with built-in reasoning and full visibility into every step. We have also Dataverse functions in preview. I can create one from the Power Apps portal. The function can have inputs and outputs and a formula containing my business logic. And the nice thing is that we can then add that function to our agent, selecting the Dataverse connector and choosing unbounded action. Can configure it, you know, with the appropriate inputs and outputs, and then that becomes one more tool at our agent disposal. Agent Flows is a new tool we have been seeing for a few weeks now. Microsoft is actively working on it, and at the Build conference they presented Intelligent Approvals. Intelligent Approvals inserts an AI-powered decision-making stage directly within the advanced approval action. You simply provide natural language business rules and select your desired AI model. The model then evaluates submitted materials, images, documents, databases, or knowledge articles to deliver a transparent approve or reject decision, complete with a detailed rationale. The challenge in building any kind of agent is making sure it responds accurately, you know, when users ask different types of questions. So this is where the new evaluation capabilities in Copilot Studio comes in. Now you can run automated tests against your agent directly from the testing panel. You can upload your set of questions, import queries from the chat history, or even generate new questions using AI. You can then review, edit each question before running the test. Then you can run the evaluation and get a visual summary of the evaluation results. You can now publish your agent to WhatsApp, but more importantly, you can publish it to SharePoint Online now. That's another long-awaited feature, because so far it wasn't possible to have a SharePoint agent with actions and other advanced features. Now, finally, you can. Let me just point out, though, that if you create your SharePoint agent from SharePoint, you can't customize it in Copilot Studio yet. So this works only if you start from Copilot Studio and then publish to SharePoint. The vice versa is not possible yet. Copilot Studio agents can now generate charts, and that's done using the new code interpreter feature. As you can see, Python code is generated automatically after your prompt. You can even see it and reuse it, and it executes and generates the chart. With native source control integration, you can take your agents in your environment and connect it to a source control repository, such as Azure DevOps, and make commits from the UI directly, so that everything you do is source controlled and is managed in the same way that you would expect any software to be managed. And finally, for the real nerds, the extension to Visual Studio Code allows you to clone agents to your machine locally and start editing the code behind it. You'll get here syntax error highlighting, autocomplete, documentation, and so forth. So really, lots going on with Copilot Studio, which is really getting a very powerful product. So put a like and subscribe to my channel if you like my work. And thanks for watching.